La Vol de la Joconde, or The Theft of the Mona Lisa, follows Chantal Dufour, her nephew Jean-Pierre, and his friend Jacques on an epic adventure to find out who and how stole the Mona Lisa out of the Louvre, or if it was even taken out at all. At 6 o'clock in the morning, Jean-Pierre wakes up to the sound of a phone ringing.
Who is calling at this hour? Eli, Cesar!
Le patron, it's urgent.
What's going on?
Nothing. Passette voici.
Oh,
top secret.
Come on.
Nope. I'll be back tonight. Stay out of trouble.
When you try your best, but you don't succeed.
Looks like she's headed toward the Louvre. This could be très intéressant. I should call Jacques.
Jean-Pierre was born in Paris, but he now lives in Bordeaux. He's staying with his aunt Chantal, who works for La Sûreté, the French equivalent of the FBI. Jacques is his best friend, who also lives in Paris.
Look at La Voiture Officielle. It has a tricolored flag on a license plate. And look, it's La Présidente de la République and La Maire de Paris. Oh look, and there's Inspector Granger. And here comes Chantal.
Chantal?
With the help of some extensive snooping, the two amateur detectives discovered that the Mona Lisa herself had been stolen and replaced with a very realistic fake.
Open the lock. Two ways of opening your
arm. Meanwhile, inside the Louvre, the conservator explains to Inspector Granger that, in order to turn off the alarm system, one would need a key, as well as the fingerprints of one of three people, the conservator himself, the head guard, or the police commissioner. This is Zed. Zed is a world-known English thief. Granger suspected Zed and Leturk, but Leturk passed away, and Zed is now Granger's prime suspect.
His last known whereabouts are Kefalonia, an island in Greece.
To avoid scandal, the Louvre remained open. This is La Valliere,
an old man who is crazy, but harmless, and obsessed with the Mona Lisa. He visits the Louvre every day to visit the artworks at the museum.
Upon realization that La Valliere's beloved Mona Lisa was indeed a fake, he became very distraught and très agité. Out of his despair, he attempted to commit suicide.
Ah, zut alors! I cannot live another day without La Joconde, my beloved Mona Lisa.
The two boys entered the Louvre. It was there that they met one of the guards, Roger Leroux. He promised to show the boys the secret passages of the Louvre.
Are you a guard here?
Oui, je m'appelle Roger Leroux.
Je m'appelle Jean-Pierre, mon ami Jacques. What do you think of this whole thing?
I think nothing.
Nothing at all.
It's none of my business.
One day later.
Let it seize on air. Okay, where are the hidden staircases? Follow me. This place is like a maze.
Chantal, is it possible that the Mona Lisa is actually hidden in the reserve?
See, Inspector Granger already thought of that. He checked it very thoroughly, and he didn't find it, so I don't think there's any possible way it's there. See you guys later.
Let's go check it in.
How are we gonna get in, you idiot?
I have the key from Chantal.
All these paintings, it has to be in here somewhere.
I guess my aunt was right. Je me suis trompé.
Let's get out of here. This place is getting... down here again.
Mais qui? Qui êtes-vous?
Yeah, who are you?
That's of little importance. If you value your lives, you'll never set foot in the reserve again. Ooh, ah, Lord.
Ooh, ah, Lord? Or else what?
You heard me. I'm leaving now.
We have to call him.
Ah, zut, we missed him.
Wait. J'ai déjà entendu cette voix.
You think his voice was familiar?
Upon recounting their experience to Chantal, she told them that she believed it was possible that La Joconde was in the reserve after all, hidden beneath a layer of special acrylic paint. The trio quickly departed to test their theory.
The vinyl cover will be shiny, right?
Yeah, we should probably look for one that's more, like, new. But look how many there are. This is really disparaging.
Wait, look at this one. Regarde comme Bria.
more time. Pardon moi. At least you don't spend much time in museums.
Look at this one. It's pretty simple.
Yeah, look. The corners are dark.
Let me see that. Oh my god, this is it. Mon Dieu, c'est ça!
Me voix, the familiar voice. I know who it was.
What?
Was it? It was.
Huh? Wait, what are you... What?
Chantal. She works for La Sirete.
Oh, enchanté.
We found the Mona Lisa.
Oh, really? Where?
Under a painting in La Réserve.
How did you figure that one out?
Figure out what?
Elementary, mon cher monsieur.
And the familiar voice?
We know it was you.
Moi?
Him? You? You're the thief?
I'm not a thief. I had no intentions of harming the Mona Lisa.
Well, then, why replace it?
I was young. I was 20 years old. When I was young, I had dreams of becoming a painter. It took me 10 years to make La Joconde. 10 years, mon ami. 10 years it took me to reproduce La Joconde. And it is good. It is very good. For 5 days of glory, I got to call myself Leonardo da Vinci. Cinq jours de gloire!
I have to place you under arrest, and you're gonna go to jail for a really long time for this.
Wait, no one was hurt, except for La Valliere. I think we can come to a compromise.
I won't turn you in under one condition.
Yes, anything!
You have to give your fake Mona Lisa, the Mona Lisa that took you 10 years to reproduce, to La Valliere.
Yes, yes, thank you!
Let's discuss this further over lunch.
LaRue agreed to the ultimatum presented by Chantal, and in the end, everything came together. Roger explained that the gun he had wasn't really a gun, but a very strange cigarette lighter. He also told them he had managed to stop the alarm by drugging his friend, La Guardian Chef, during a card game. He copied his key and fingerprints.
It turns out Zed was guilty, but not because he stole the Mona Lisa. Grandier arrested Zed and his accomplices in Greece, not because they stole the Mona Lisa, but because they were planning on robbing the bank of France.
Everyone was happy, but La Valliere? He was perhaps the happiest of all.
L.A. Treybell. She's even more beautiful than the original.
Make new friends, tie that yarn, that's how you do the scorn. That's a wrap.